Happy morning to all my dear students. I hope you are fine and fit at home. Today we are going to see Unit 2, Prose. The title of the prose is The Last Stone Carver. You can call it also The Last Stone Mason. It is a very beautiful story. You can read and understand the story. How we can keep up our culture. This is what the grandfather is trying to tell us. Now let us see about the author. Sigrun Srivastav. Sigrun Srivastav is an Indian author of German origin. She is a multifaceted artist, a writer, a sculptor, and an illustrator. As a writer, she has written over 25 books for children of all ages. Her interest as an illustrator and a writer come together in her picture books for preschool children. She was born in the year 1943. Her books, A Moment of Truth, True Stories from Around the World. In this story, deals about the traditional work, sculpturing, and the beauty of the profession. This is the central theme of the prose. Now let us see the little bit of summary about it. The young man, he sat still. There are often differences in young people's ideas and opinions and older people's ideas. Do these differences cause problems between young and old people? Between parents and children? This is a story about a difference of opinion between an old man and his son and what happens as a result. The old man makes statues. He is a sculptor. He is poor, but he loves his work. He believes that making statues of gods and goddesses out of stone is like worshipping God, because this is the work God wants him to do. He makes each statue lovingly and patiently. He wants his son to learn the same art and continue the family tradition. But his son thinks that carving statues for temples by hand takes too long and does not help them earn much money. He wants to make things that will be easier, and the last stone mason notes 208 English secondary courses faster to carve so that he will be able to make them in large numbers of rich tourists to buy. In this way, it will be possible to earn much more money and end their poverty. He says goodbye to his sad father and the family profession and leaves his home angrily. He is leaving his home angrily and going away to another place to do other jobs. Our traditional art and craft, which are an important part of our culture and heritage, are dying out. Is that true, children? Our traditional art and craft is dying out. Let us see because of what. Why are these traditional craft dying out? Maybe it is because the handicrafts trade does not fetch much money. Whatever the things are made out of hand, it is not getting more money. Artisans struggle hard to make both ends meet. They don't have adequate material to make products. They need markets to sell their products, but there isn't much demand for their products. Whatever things made out of hand, it is not selling. They are not in demand of. Young artisans want to earn more money and are in favor of mass productions of items than can be products quickly rather than by hand. See, nowadays the people want things are made quickly, not the things that are made by hand. This makes them leave their family handicraft industry. So because of all these reasons, they have to leave the job of what they were making earlier, that are made by the hand. Should they do this? Should we let our traditional art and craft die out? Can we do anything to stop it? This lesson will make you think about all these questions, about the problems faced by young artisans, and what we need to do to solve these problems. Dear children, what can we do to solve these problems? Is that we can continue the traditional work which are carried out by our parents, or we should adopt the later what is coming up, the demand of the people. We have to think about it, children. You know that nowadays your parents are going for, your father is going for fishing. Do you want to continue that job, or you want to do better than that job? You want to do better than that job so that you are coming to the school to learn and to become a better person. You want to earn money better than that. So, dear children, this lesson will teach you. So, listen to this story and learn it. Read this 5 times.
I am leaving you and this work. After all these years of work, this is all we have. Nothing. This kind of work just doesn't pay.
It's not only the money that matters, son. It's the service. Our service to God.
Father, times have changed. The stonemason's work has changed too. You can't live on sculptures for temples only. You have to mass produce like all the others in Agra.
No, my son. We have kept up this tradition for hundreds of years, and I hope you would continue our work.
No, Father. There is much more money in ashtrays and plates for tourist shops. I am tired of working for a pittance. I am leaving, Father. Goodbye.
Masterji, Masterji.
Salim, soon I will be the last stone mason here. All the others would have gone to Agra. They are making money, but they betray our skill, our age-old tradition. Now Gopal has also gone. I'll have to finish this sculpture alone. And with the help of God, I'll do it, Salim.
I know you will, Masterji. You'll make many more, larger and more beautiful temple sculptures.
My strength is waning. I can't work with the chisel like I used to. I'll have to finish this work, and surely I will.
Yes, you will. Drink, please. It will do you good.
The old man sighed and picked up the chisel and hammer. The cool metal of the tools filled him with happiness and confidence. He loved his work and didn't want to change it for any other in the world. Days and weeks went by. It was a month since Gopal had left. The old man worked tirelessly. On and on he worked. But then came the day when the old man felt his strength ebb.
Masterji, you haven't touched your food again.
I don't think I'll be able to finish it. If Gopal was here, it would be different. He wasn't the best of craftsmen, but he was good and strong. It was the features and hands that gave him trouble. There was something missing in his figures. That's something which can't be taught.
Because it comes from somewhere deep inside you.
You are right, Salim. And if you don't have it here, then you'd better go to Agra and mass produce ashtrays for the tourists from abroad.
Eat, Masterji. Everything will be all right.
After he had eaten, the old man once again took up his hammer and chisel. He worked till late in the night. He prayed for help and strength, and he prayed for his son. In the early hours of the morning, the chisel fell from his hand and the hammer dropped to the ground.
Hi, Ram.
Gopal, he was back. He would help him. They would finish the statue. He crossed the small room and reached the door.
Salim? I only wanted to help. I'll learn if you teach me, Masterji. Please tell me. For many years, I wanted to become a sculptor. Yet, I fought the feeling. But it proved too strong. I know there is nothing in this world I would like to do more. There is nothing in life I could do better. Will you please teach me, Masterji?
There's nothing I can teach you, my son. Go ahead. You have it in your hands and in your heart. I know you will be one of the country's finest stone masons.
Now let us see the glossary. Congested, overcrowded, crouching, sitting on heels, determination, firmness to do something, serene, calm. So, congested means overcrowded. Crouching, sitting on heels. Determination, firmness to do something, serene, calm. So, learn this lesson and read it properly.